Hey everybody, this is Michael once again, and welcome back to another video. Well guys, as you can see down there, I am reviewing the film End of Watch. Now before I begin guys, let me say that many of you have asked why I haven't done a top 10 favorite films from 2012, or for that matter, a least favorite video of films from 2012. Well, there's several films from 2012 that I haven't seen. And I'm actually in the process of catching up and seeing those films, at least the films that I really wanted to see. And I don't want to make a list until I see these films because undoubtedly some of them may be on my best films of 2012, or for that matter, my least favorite films from 2012. So that's the reason why I'm catching up on some of the films that I really want to see. As a matter of fact, I saw one today, and that, of course, was End of Watch. End of Watch, guys. Now, this is a film that was directed by David Ayer. David Ayer's directed about four films, and unfortunately, all the films that he's directed I've never seen. But he has written quite a few films that I have actually seen that he didn't direct, but he did write these movies. And one of them, at the top of the list, is Training Day. Now, this is the vehicle that starred Denzel Washington in one of his most memorable roles, and a film that's considered one of his best. So, Ayer wrote that film quite impeccably, I do have to say as well. And he also wrote another very, very well-known film, and that movie is The Fast and the Furious, the very first film he wrote that movie. So, the guy's got some skill behind him. He's a decent writer. Now, End of Watch is a film that he not only directed, but he also wrote. This movie is a found footage film, and I gotta tell you guys, if it wasn't for the trailer presenting these two main characters in the film, these very interesting characters, which I believe the trailer conveyed, I would have never seen this film, because quite frankly, I am fed up to here with found footage films, and most of them are garbage. But anyway, I decided to give this film a watch, guys, because I thought the characters were intriguing. End of Watch is, like I said, a found footage film. And before I move on to the story itself, let's talk a little bit about the actors. And I'm going to tell you the stars of the film, but the first guy, his name is almost utterly ridiculous for me to pronounce, but I'll do the best I can. Now, the film stars Jake Gyllenhaal, or Gyllenhaal. And he plays a character named Brian Taylor. And then we have Michael Peña, who plays Mike Zavala. And these guys are not only cops, but they're also best friends. And they share a beat together. They share a car together. And the film shows us their day-to-day routine. Now, some of you might be wondering, how could this be found footage? You know, it's pretty, you can't film what a cop's doing. So what's the reason behind this actually be a found footage film? Well, one of the officers plans on breaking into filmmaking, So he uses that excuse, and I mean, it's a legitimate excuse in the film. That's he's wanting to get into filmmaking, and he's completing an assignment for his filming class so that he can turn it in. So he mounts a camera to his chest and then his partner's chest, and there's even some dialogue in the film where he says, hey, you know, with these cameras, you can film me, I can film you, we can catch what's going on around us. And he also has a handheld camera that he carries with him. But interestingly enough, guys, there's some scenes in the film that are just impossible to capture from the angles that the film shows. I mean, it's supposed to be a found footage film, but at the same time, you're seeing the top of the police car when it's going down the road. You're seeing angles of the officers while they talk in the car that would be virtually impossible to get with these chest-mounted cameras. So you're seeing all these interesting angles, and in my head, I'm thinking, does the film want to be a found footage film, or does it just want to be a regular movie film? So you have both these scenes, both these techniques in this one film that's a found footage film, and you know, there's nobody else around filming anything but these guys, and they're sitting straight forward in the car, and you're getting all these angles, and you're thinking, found footage or conventional film? Well, which one is it going to be? But anyway, that's a slight distraction I had with the movie, because I'm thinking, you know, it might have been more realistic just to go with the found footage angle. I mean, if you're going to show all these other angles that you can't get with found footage cameras, then just make a regular film. But anyway, just a quaint little nitpick there, guys. But we're seeing, in the film, we're seeing the two cops on their beat. They're answering three or four calls in the film. And at the same time, we're getting to meet the families of the cops. We're getting to delving into their friendship. They're really close. We're delving into their relationships with one of the cops is married and his wife's pregnant. One of the other cops has met a new girl. They're becoming close. So we're kind of following not only their job as police officers, we're also following their personal lives. And they're intermingled together, overlapping, but they never conflict with each other. So, you know, it's definitely not a romantic story, the personal lives, even though there is a relationship going on. It's more just a day-to-day capture of what's going on in their lives instead of just, you know, straight solid story. And sometimes you even feel like you're just watching several clips thrown together of these guys experiencing day-to-day life. And if you really think about it, that's probably the way a found footage film should be, instead of just a straightforward, continuous story like a lot of them are. So anyway, we're getting to know these characters. We're getting to know them on a personal level. We're getting to see their friendship. And one day, the two officers encounter a human trafficking ring. Now, right when they're about to investigate, the federal government pulls up and kicks them off the scene of the crime. And one of the agents warns them that, you know, you guys are over your head. You better look behind you. Basically, you're a target now. And so an undisclosed leader of the human trafficking or drug smuggling ring puts a hit out on the cops. And a gang is sent to kill them. Now, I'll stop right there, guys, because this is a movie, as I've said several times in reviews, that definitely depend on you seeing it for yourself the first time and me not ruining anything for you. End of Watch is definitely a different type of found footage film. It's a movie that, hard for me to say if you would like it or not, because I think most of the public, the general public, is getting really, really tired of found footage films. But this one offers a kind of a refreshing change in found footage films. Not only do you have really, really good characters here, but you have a story that develops these characters in a way that it seems natural and not forced. And I'll also say, guys, that, you know, when you're sitting in here watching this film and you're seeing these two guys together on their beat, joking with each other, telling these stories about their girlfriends, and you can definitely identify. If you've had a best friend or a close friend or whatever, and I know you all have, you can definitely identify with these two guys being together, these two guys sharing stories. So that was really I mean, we got a found footage film that has interesting characters and characters that you can care about. And I found that really, really refreshing because basically, despite all the gunplay in the film, despite all the blood squibs and all that, this movie is, at its heart, a friendship movie. And you have these two officers becoming entangled in their personal lives. They're meeting one another's girlfriends. They're getting to know each other's mates. And we're watching all this. We're getting to know these characters. And they're definitely characters that drew me into the story, because as I'm watching this film, by the end of the movie, I'm really, really emotionally invested in these characters, and I really feel I care about these people. So, now if you go into End of Watch for an action piece, you're going to be disappointed, because, I mean, even though there are action scenes in the film, it's not an action movie. Like I said, at its heart, it's a movie about friendship and the things that friends share with each other. I appreciated it for that. You know, it's nice to watch a film with a heart, and this film has a lot of heart. I was pleasantly surprised by it. So I definitely got to recommend End of Days, guys. Two great performances by the lead actors. And even the supporting cast, the other officers in the film, the romantic entanglements that each gentleman has. You know, it's almost like watching a movie that consists of people that you may know, or people that you're really, really close to. It's almost like you're watching their lives, and you get pulled into that, you get wrapped up into that, and it definitely pulls on the old heartstrings when you watch this story. And there's even times when there is quite a bit of tension in this film, because you're watching these characters that you really, really like in these situations where, you know, something untoward could happen, and you're sitting there, you know, thinking, God, I hope nothing happens to these guys. You know, I like this character. Oh my God, he just had a baby. Please watch this character. So, you know, there is quite a bit of tension there. And it's definitely a film that I enjoyed. You know, with a budget of only $7 million, and you can definitely see on screen, because there's nothing really on screen that would need a lot of money. But as you're watching this film, at $7 million, it went on the gross, I believe, $42 million. So it definitely turned to profits several times over. And it's definitely deserving of a film that, unfortunately, even though it did make a profit, a lot of people aren't aware of this film. And I think it's definitely a film you should give a shot and give a watch. I think it's a film that, you know, when you watch it, it'll definitely bring up a lot of true life feelings. But anyway, check out End of Watch, guys. Definitely worth the time. Thanks for watching. I'm continuing to watch 2012 movies, so we will have more reviews from films from 2012. And as a matter of fact, guys, tomorrow, I believe we're going to see the new Tom Cruise film, and I'm looking forward to that because I'm a big supporter of Tom Cruise. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, and I'll see you at the next movie review.